What's up, guys? I'm outside because I want to show you the camera features of the Oppo Find 7. This is one of the most impressive cameras that I've ever seen and used. As a matter of fact, if I left my DSLR at home, I wouldn't be mad or upset if I had this phone on me, because I know that the camera, the quality is going to be very, very good. As a matter of fact, everything that you see here in this video, including right now, I'm shooting with the Oppo Find 7 in 4K. So without further ado, let's get started. So this very first picture I actually posted on Google Plus. A lot of you guys were really impressed by it, especially because of the dynamic range. You actually thought that I had used HDR, some of you did. And I actually took some video footage so you can see that what you see is exactly what you get. Very impressive colors and the accuracy is right on. So I wanted to shoot in different locations, indoor, outdoors, and my first location was a hardware store where I found this really cool looking car in a parking lot. I started in the garden department because there's a lot of color there with flowers. This day was really hot, it was really warm, and the picture really depicts that. Because this camera has an f2.0 aperture, you get really nice depth of field even when it's bright daylight. Now here's a picture where you could really see that depth of field that I was talking about, where the flower is in focus and the background is blurred out. Now when we start to zoom in closer, you can see that that sharpness, even at 100% crop, is right there and it's very nice and crispy. What I think really impressed me about this camera the most is the color accuracy. Take for example this picture here. There's a lot of different colors, and the reason why I took this picture is to see how accurate it is compared to what I saw. And I can tell you right now, exactly what you see is exactly what I saw. This forklift was really interesting because it was really dirty, pretty beat up. It had a lot of different textures, the color variations from black and white. And I really like that you can see that in the picture, and also on video, you can really capture that. Including on the backside, you can really see inside the motor, even though it was pretty dark. So I moved my way inside the lumberyard, mainly because the lighting will be a little bit different and I wanted to see if the colors were going to change. And everything that you see here is exactly how I saw it. All the colors were 100% accurate, and even towards the back where there was not a lot of light towards this gate, it was still pretty impressive that it was able to retain a lot of color and values, because believe it or not, there was not a lot of light here. So another thing that really impressed me with this camera was the automatic white balance. As you can see here from the toilets, these are white but also more of a bone color. Now one thing to know, inside the lumberyard you have natural light from the sky, but you also have the indoor lighting, so there's a lot of different variations, but the automatic white balance is really, really accurate. So I decided to go to one of my favorite spots, Victoria Gardens, which is an outdoor mall. The sun was going to set in about an hour or so, so I wanted to take some pictures before sundown. You can see how beautiful the sky looks. All of the colors are so accurate. And even when we're at 100% zoom towards this sign, you could see how crisp and sharp. And when we start pulling back, all of the details are there and the whole picture just looks really beautiful. A really quick video of the courtyard where there's a lot going on, a lot of different colors and textures. You could really see the dynamic range and everything just looks really good. In this part of the courtyard, at this time, there's really not a lot of light available in this area because of the buildings, but the video really showcases how great that f2.0 aperture really works. So as you can see from the background, the sun is setting, and I really like this picture because the rough walls compared to the smoothness of the bucks. And when you zoom in at 100%, you could really appreciate the detail. So even though the sun was setting and we were kind of in a position where there was not a lot of light, it still was able to capture all of that detail. So here's a picture of the front plaza where the sun is setting on the left. I also took video so you guys can see how the picture and the video are almost exactly the same in terms of color reproduction. Here's a picture of a palm tree at 100% crop. You can see from the sky, there's no weird fringing because of the palm trees. There's a lot of small little fine details. And when we start pulling back to reveal the whole entire image, you can see how nice and warm the picture is to show that there is a sunset happening in the background. So I took this picture because there's a lot of different textures going on here. You have a lot of wood, but you also have some brick in the background, a little bit of a smooth wall on the left, and some cement showing on the bottom left-hand side. Now this picture does appear a little bit brighter than how I saw it, but that's okay because I like that I can edit this image and kind of adjust the contrast to make it a little bit more darker and have a lot of room to play with. So this is the last picture I took outside where the sun was pretty much set, but you still have enough light where you can get a little bit of the background, and of course all of the signs and the lighting from the building. Really nice picture. I can tell you that I would probably love to take this to Las Vegas, where there's plenty of lights, and take some pretty awesome pictures. So after an evening of shooting, I decided to go to Pinkberry and get me a yogurt. And of course, I had to record to see how the interior lighting would affect the quality. And remember, I'm shooting behind a glass. I think it looks pretty good. Let me know what you think. So there's one more picture I want to show you guys, and it's this of a flower sitting on a wooden chest. Now, something about this picture or this particular scene is that there was very little light. If you look at the XF data, you'll notice that it's an F2.0 with a 1600 ISO. Now, my wife had her iPhone there, and I decided to make a comparable or take a comparable picture to see the difference. And this is the one of the iPhone. You can see it's very bland. This is at 100% crop. And I'll go back to the one on the Oppo Find 7 so you can see the regular one. And now let me zoom in at 100%. There's a big difference. And you can see that megapixels do count, and also aperture, and of course the quality of the camera. So hopefully that puts things in perspective so you guys can see the really good quality that the Oppo Find 7 has. So there you have it. The Oppo Find 7 is a very impressive camera. I'm gonna leave a link down below where you can download all of the images that you saw here, including some other ones that I did not post. And I'm also going to include the picture of the iPhone 5S if you guys wanna check that out. Anyhow, guys, I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and reshare this with all of your friends and family. Until next time, adios.